traditions keep the generations of students together. They keep us connected. It's something that will carry through the time. So I know there are big traditions that will probably always stand, but for me, it's some of the little teeny traditions.
Just like company mission statements, you know, they sound great, but you know, how many actually follow through? And the most striking thing here was that, you know, what they said, they actually do.
You know, I mean, I think there's something very unique about LP students and LP families. There's something that kind of sets us apart, you know. I mean, at the end of the day, when I'm wearing my, you know, LP parent name tag at the admissions fairs, you know, I definitely feel like I'm representing something that's worthwhile and very, very special.
And to this day, you know, some of my oldest friends are from here, you know, and that is something I'm very proud of. Yeah, I've had a lot of amazing experiences through the LP, some of which were academic, many of which weren't, but so beneficial.
That kids, students, they weren't even kids anymore, they were my kids, but they were in their late teens, early 20s, and they would come back right before going to college, in the middle of college, and suddenly I'd see a face that looked so familiar and yet so different at the same time. A particular memory of a child who was about to go off to boarding school, and he came and he sat on one of the desks and helped me erase the boards, and it was, you know, late June, and I could kind of tell that for this child, he was really thinking about what was coming next and what that would mean to leave home, and the fact that he came here to sit with himself in a way, and with me doing correcting and cleaning and sort of chatting with him about nothing but maybe about everything at the same time was really kind of neat.
There was no pressure to conform. There was no large community that you felt like you had to change and adapt to. That really the school did more adapting to you than you did to it. And it really allowed for folks to explore and discover what were those elements that were completely unique to them.
Happened across the LP, and I was immediately drawn to, you know, its size, its location, you know, and the community. Really, it's the small school in the city, but it has such a wide vision, you know, and its impacts are so far-reaching.
And it was about learning through doing, which I thought also was really great. You know, we didn't just learn about the public transit system. We learned by riding it, by, you know, experiencing it, by, you know, I remember our final being dropped off in some random area. I think I was in Watertown at the time that I'd never been to before, with a chaperone who was instructed to not assist us at all. And we had to make our way back to school, you know. So that kind of hands-on learning, I think, is something that I absolutely treasure, I think.
You know, I haven't been disappointed. I mean, every year, you know, it's a new teacher, a new classroom setting. They're focusing on different issues, you know, and they just seem to handle it, you know, with such finesse, with such style. And just
again, sort of feeding back to the smallness of the school. So I think it's really good. And the teachers, as I think I said earlier, the teachers and the staff, they really know him. It's clear that they know him, and that's quite a privilege, you know, when your child is in an environment where there is a lot of care and attention to them, a lot of dedication to teaching here. And you end up with a happy kid, basically.
It means a commitment to having a rigorous curriculum. I think that too, for all of us who have taught here and who love learning and love teaching, that there is that expectation to be doing real work at all times. So the faculty are dedicated. They are fun, so much fun. I've made friends that I will have for life. But it's the intensity of the work that we do together. It's the common dedication to the mission, to being a truly excellent, excellent educator. It was not unusual to walk in the door of the Learning Project at 6 a.m. in January and not be the first one here. It was not unusual to leave the Learning Project at 6 p.m., 6:30 p.m., 7 p.m., and not be the last one here in June or May when it's beautiful and all you want to do is be outside. It started to feel, well, this is a place where people work together, that they work hard, but that the work isn't burdensome. I think the openness that the school has to doing things better, if we can, is really liberating as a teacher, that you can present an idea. I think of several things that changed over the time that I was here. The sixth graders were not reading Shakespeare when I came, and that happened to be a particular love of mine. And I said, well, that would be kind of neat to do in the spring, something really sort of challenging to help them feel like they're big kids. And Michael was open to that crazy idea.
The fact that, it's a small school, there are limitations with the size physically, but you end up with an amazing campus. You've got like Boston, that's your campus. You've got the Boston Public Library is effectively the school library and so on. So there's actually a huge resource by virtue of being, in the city.
This is a place that values their teachers, that sees their teachers as a part of the community, that school isn't just school. School is a place where people feel at home, where they make friendships, friendships that last for years and years and years. And this little tiny building tucked away on a beautiful side street is home to so many.
Out of all the schools that I've gone to, the LP is the only reunion that I would ever consider going to. It doesn't even occur to me to go to high school reunions or junior high reunions or college or whatever.
In fact, having been a sixth grade teacher for many years, I had the benefit of seeing over time what a touchstone place Learning Project is for its students.
It really helps to grow these global citizens, these citizens that can think beyond their small space, in the world.
Looking for a place in the earth that will feed and nurture our children, we search as parents for the ideal environment, the soil that will provide our seeds with the optimum bloom potential. Speaking for my husband and myself, as LP parents, I feel very blessed to have been given the opportunity to plant our little seeds in the garden found at 107 Marble Street. I think it's a very rare garden you see at 107 Marble Street. It is rich with nutrients, possessing a remarkable pH that seems to adjust itself to each seed's need. The LP soil is the stuff gardeners dream of. A medieval alchemist would have declared the LP soil to be the philosopher's stone of education. But in true LP style, its alchemy produces something far richer than gold. It is the LP's dedication to the whole child, nurturing their sense of self, encouraging them to sink their roots deep into the LP community, and bloom not as individual flowers kept beautiful in a greenhouse, but blossom as part of a whole garden open into the world around them. In our application to the Learning Project, my husband, Craig, and I wrote that one of our most important gifts that we wanted to give our children was the opportunity of an education. Well, opportunity quickly became community throughout her LP experience. Potlucks, book fairs, Mayfest, trick-or-treat for UNICEFs, readathons, Zudios, Olympics, and graduations have helped our family roots grow deep within the LP soil. And somehow, our gift to our children, Kai and Sujin, has become a gift to us.
Come to me for to ease my pain.